Good afternoon, friends. This is time for the trade plan for 26th of May 2020. Now, in terms of the overall environment, in terms of the economy opening up, it is limping back to normal. And I am saying this anecdotally, given the amounts of traffic that is on the roads, given the amount of quote-unquote security measures that colonies and people are taking, no economy can grow to its full potential if there is restriction on movement. If small business, restaurants, hotels, malls are not being allowed to function, if offices are only allowing 50% staff, and there is all kinds of trouble for in getting migrant labor, etc. This is domestic. Now, globally, there is a geopolitical situation which is developing between China and the US, although Chinese troops are also on our borders. So it adds an extra bit of problem to our markets. And basically, the FIIs remain on the sell side, and that way, institutionally, the problem with this RBI conference was that they have no option but to keep on allowing more and more moratorium. Okay. And while all kinds of guarantees are being given by the government, we know what happens later on. You make a commercial decision and then all kinds of CVG, CAG is let loose on you, and the banker, poor guy is doing a job, he is not likely to give risky loans. As far as COVID is concerned, the cases are rocketing. What that does is that creates a fear psychosis. Even if there aren't too many people who are dying, but doing all those safety measures, restricting movement of people, being in some kind of partial lockdown all the time, that is more a hindrance. I just visited drove past a Croma store, and there were five people standing outside it because they only allow one or two customers inside. In this kind of a situation, can you expect massive sales? I don't think so. So that is the overall environment. Now, the trade plan for tomorrow is that we are in sell on rally mode. So Nifty right now, the SGX is up about 45 at about 9080. So any level in between 9090 to 9142 should be used to sell, and you could take profits around 89.40 to about 89.90. So 89.90 is one target, 89.40 could be the second target. A stop above 9142 is a reasonable stop. Bank Nifty, again, if you find a rally, all of these are futures levels. So please mark that down, that any rallies towards 17530 to 17800 should be used to sell. Now, how do you sell between these two levels? If you find price rejection, you have a green candle which goes into these two levels and is quickly cleaned up by a red candle. Rejection does not mean those small little bars. Rejection means a large substantial bar which takes out green of one or more candles. So you sell as the price gets to 17530 to 17800 for targets of 17050 to about 16800. Again, stop here could be above 17800 and the first target is 17050 and the second target could be 16800. In terms of stocks and sectors, it is very clear that financials are in trouble. So all kinds of financial stocks on rallies should be sold into. All sorts of FMCG, pharma, etc. and IT, you can buy into them. Obviously, these are things where you need proper levels to buy into. What I am giving you is my bias on individual stocks and sectors. So within that, you know, you need to do your own sort of analysis to find a trade plan. See, the difference between a trade plan and a view is quote unquote kya lag raha hai, and a trade plan is an exact plan where you know where you need to do what and how do you manage that trade in terms of a stop, in terms of a target. In the previous video, Getting Intimate with Camarilla, I have described how you can design a trade plan for individual stocks. So listen to that video again and you should be able to make a trade plan for the indices as well as 4 or 5 individual stocks. The sense is that you know, this kind of a situation will remain with us till the end of this year. You have a US election, and this time I think Trump has realized that he is going to win only if he takes aggressive position against China, and China will do everything to put him into trouble because China does not want Trump to come back. Okay, so this is going to be the big backdrop. This COVID situation in India, you know, the problem with us is we get into hypocrisy. What is hypocrisy? That we don't understand we are dealing with a virus, with a disease, not with some sort of intruders. So closing the economy, closing, you know, colony gates, etc., is not going to help. I think community spread is on our hands, and you're adding 6,000 to 7,000 cases only because lockdowns are only useful to the extent that it buys you time. It does not stop corona, and we need to recognize that. So the earlier we do that, the better off we will be. My sense is that we have done irreparable damage, and irreparable damage, the reason for that is now that we want to restart our industry, we don't have labor. So how do you restart? Who works on the assembly lines? So plus we have no money. You cannot solve a crisis just, you know, with making people take on debts they cannot get out of. Urban poverty will increase if hotels, malls, restaurants, they go out of business. So we are going to come out of this, you know, a lot worse than we are getting out, and only because this fear of corona will not let us restart the way we should be. The US has much higher number of patients, but they are reopening because they understand that finally business is important. And if closing down is easy, opening up is not like pulling up shutters of a shop and restarting everything. So I hope we give economy the seriousness it deserves, instead of thinking that everywhere we should put our restrictions and people start to treat these as a problems that they have to get over. It encourages corruption, because finally what will happen is people will start to ask for money to allow certain things. So, these partial lockdowns, etc., is not going to work. So, very important that, we get on with business. That should be it. Take care, trade well, and please consult your financial advisor.